Amazon rainforest is a sprawling jungle stretching across 5.5 million square kilometers, an area over half the size of Europe. The Amazon has existed for an estimated 55 million years, but what if it never existed? Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions, a channel that looks to answer a plethora of queries from reality to fiction, from science to history to pop culture. We are one of the OG homes of the what if discussion video. I'm your host, Rebecca Felgate, and today I am asking, true to form, what if the Amazon rainforest never existed? Before we get into this video, I want to know what your favorite animal is that lives in the rainforest. You can Google it if you want. I'm gonna go with pink river dolphins because, you know, dolphins that are pink, doing their thing. It's just good stuff. Let me know your thoughts in the comments section down below. Also, please do leave a thumbs up on this video. It really, really helps us with the channel. If you haven't yet subscribed, go ahead and do so. We answer questions daily. All right, Amazon, what say you? The Amazon is big. It's around 56% of the size of the United States of America, or 13 times bigger than the state of California. Answering a question that asks what the world would have been like without 0.04% of its entire landmass that's housed plant and animal life for millions of years. I mean, honestly, truly, who knows? But I will tell you what I do know, and we'll make a bit of an estimation. Firstly, let me start with my beloved pink dolphins, because honeys would not be there, and nor would an absolute plethora of life forms. The Amazon is home to 10% of all of the wildlife species that we know about, and plenty that we don't. A new species is found in the Amazon every 3 days. The Amazon is the known home of 1,300 bird species, 3,000 types of fish, 430 mammals, 2.5 million different insects. According to the World Wildlife Fund, the Amazon has more types of ant on one tree than some entire countries. The Amazon also contains a third of the world's known plant species, which have been used to generate important medicines over our human history. These days, medicines to treat or cure inflammation, rheumatism, diabetes, malaria, heart conditions, skin diseases, arthritis, glaucoma, and more are made with Amazonian plant life. Without these ingredients, Western medicine would not be where it is today, and that in itself has many, many different far-reaching consequences in a butterfly effect. Beyond that, the Amazon is a valuable resource for rubber, varnish, paint, and wood finishings, as well as cosmetics such as soap and shampoos, perfumes, detergents, and the like. Sure, these play less of a role in human survival than medicine, but they have generated industry and boosted global economies. Further to that, the Amazon has given the world wood. Furniture and structures made from teak, mahogany, rosewood, balsa, and sandalwood come from the Amazon. Although its extraction has become unsustainable, it has had a big impact in the way that we've built structures. The most two precious resources that Amazon has offered to the world over the years are oxygen produced from the rainforest and fresh water via the enormous Amazon River. It is largely quoted that the Amazon rainforest creates 20% of the Earth's oxygen, although a recent article on the BBC claimed it was more like 10%. Either way, it's a significant amount of oxygen, and without it, perhaps the air quality would have been altered. The rainforest and the river are part and parcel. One would struggle to exist without the other, and the massive river with all of its tributaries contain 20% of the world's flowing fresh water. Without this, settlements in South America, countries like Brazil, Peru, and Bolivia, would not be what they are today. In general, could we have even had a Brazil without the Amazon? The short answer is probably no. The long answer would look at a lot of factors like climate, water, fuels, fibers, economy, and would still get back to no. So, one of the most important functions of the rainforest is climate and weather control. The rainforest affects rainfall patterns across South America and even beyond that. In fact, beyond that, it's suggested that the Amazon influences rainfall in Central America and the Western United States. Without the rainforest, it's likely that the land would be dry and arid, with knock-on effects across two continents, South America and North America. Remember the Mayans? It's suspected that one of the main reasons that they died out is because they overlogged that area. year. Too much deforestation led to droughts, which is why people are so concerned about the loss of the rainforest today. If the Amazon rainforest never existed, human life in South America would historically be very different. Today, the Amazon is home to more than 30 million people. Some 1.6 million of these Amazon dwellers are indigenous ancient tribes. Who is to say how civilizations would have risen and fallen if the inhabitants' land hadn't been there? While I might be finding it hard to definitively answer what would happen if the Amazon rainforest had never existed, perhaps we will know what it will be like in our time without it. While the forest has spent millions of years blooming, in just a few generations of human life, we've begun killing it off. Since the 1950s, the Amazon rainforest has lost 18% of its original forest cover, and up to 50% of the forest has been partially destroyed. The reason the rainforest is being felled at such an alarming rate is to make way for agricultural practices such as farming cattle and soybeans, for the extraction of oil and gas, for mining and for logging. If we continue at our current rate, the entire forest could be lost in 150 years, so where will we be without it? There will be more carbon dioxide in the air, that's for sure. The forest stores 86 billion tons of carbon. Temperatures would rise, which would bring about a chance of more fires. The air would be significantly more polluted, which could contribute to global health issues. And of course, with a dip in medication from eradicated Amazon resources, we could be feeling pretty sick. It is estimated that there would be significantly less rain in the west of the United States, which means less water for the population there. Down south, things would be even worse. People would be thirsty and very hungry. Without the rainforest, the Amazon River would significantly shrink, which means less water and less food. Millions of people would go hungry because the river and its tributaries are a huge source of protein across Brazil with the fish. So yeah, in my opinion, not great, to be honest with you. So that is enough of that. Let me know what you think the world would be like without the Amazon rainforest. I'm honestly very curious to know. For now though, that is all I have on this video. Please do once again click that thumbs up button and share this video with a friend. I'm your host, Rebecca Felgate. I'll catch you in the next one. Please do stay curious, stay alert, and never ever stop questioning.